Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome to an unboxing video of the Asus Cerberus, I think that's how you say it, Asus Cerberus gaming headset. So here it is, it's a bit of a reflection, but you can see, here's the headset. So, I don't think I've mentioned this, but my other headset that I use, my old cheapo headset that lasted me for about 5 years, broke. So I quickly had to order a new one, and I asked around, asked some people I knew, and they said the Asus Cerberus, which they well, some have, some don't, they said it's a good headset, and you should get it. So here I have, I've got it. So I'm just going to read you some of the stuff on the back. I'm going to zoom in so you can see for yourself. Hold it about there. So unrevealed punch and ultimate immersion. Large 60mm neodymium magnet drivers. That's how you pronounce it. As you can see though. Ingenious dual microphone design, so a detachable boom mic for gaming and inline mic for on-the-go chat. We are going to do a mic test. Undisturbed gaming and music enjoyment, comfortable 100mm full-size cushions, isolate surrounding noise. And you can see the next one, yep. Made for desktop gaming and mobile phone, compatible with PC, Mac, PlayStation 4 and smart device. And then there's like, if we zoom out, like all this information along here and whatever. And if you look on the Asus website, yeah, I'll post a link down to the bottom if I can remember. A link to the website and all the information here, it should be there. So it is, just say here as well, compatible with the PlayStation 4. I don't have a PlayStation 4, I have a PlayStation 3. So yeah, and then here, along here, it's got some of the like been given awards by like Kit Gura, can't even get that one. Hexus approved. I've heard of Kit Gura and that's it, I think. So yeah, let's get into this. There's two tabs at the top here. Never opened this, so new to me as it is to you. There we go. So that's the box. There's nothing else in the box, so we'll get rid of that. So you've got plastic covering just protecting that, there we go, and this box, it's quite heavy. I can see paper inside. So, yeah. Well, oh, there's the cables. Let's have a look at that first. We'll leave the best one last, which is the headset. Ah! Right. I believe... Ah, right. I'm going to hold that to the camera. Autofocus, please. It's not going to do it, is it? Anyway, it says alternative cable adapter for certain mobile brands. So, your old mobile phone brands would use this. I'm not sure what mobile phone brands specifically, but I can see the reason why they'd add that. Here, this is an extension. I think there is a thing here which probably tells the contents. You got your quick start guide, I guess, if you want to read that, and a VIP member warranty notice. I'll have a look at that off camera. But yeah, I believe this is an extension. So yeah, here is the actual headset itself. Here is the detachable boom mic. So this you can plug in and out. I wouldn't use this. I've got my condenser microphone. So you've got a cable running through the back here. Not that long. Anyway, let's pull this thing out. We don't need that. And here it is. Here's the headset. So I am going to do a wear test as well. So I'll show you me wearing it. And here, if you see that hole there, this is where your microphone goes in. So there we go. And we have a we have the 3.5 jack. Then that goes into there. And you've got your extension then. I think that's to enable the mic to work as well. And you've got your microphone, you've got your volume and microphone. That actually, it's only really short. I'll show you. That is that long. Come on, autofocus. It's not going to do it, is it? Anyway, so it's that long. It's 6 inch if that, and you've got your microphone mute and your audio, and it's also got a little clip so you can clip it to your shirt, and this is your extension there. Nice braided cable with gold plated ends, which is always nice to see. It's a detachable mic, you can take that out. So the headset itself, you've got only shows up in light, but you might, if I hold it like that, it's a Cerberus, and it's got this thing, right? These two here, hold it like that. These here are where all the wires go, and this here is just it's a soft band, and it stretches. See? So I can it'll show better when I've actually got it on my head. You've got your ear cups here, which move. It's like this plushy leather. It's not memory foam as such, but it's really soft, and it is quite deep inside, so you shouldn't have any problems with your ears hurting or anything. They do swivel, move like on a ballpoint, which is always nice to see. So if you've got an odd shaped head, let's say, that's always nice to see. So there we go, like that. I think that's about it. So if I get this plugged in now, I'll show you it on my head, and we'll do a mic test. Right then, so here it is, and as you can see, it is quite big. It is quite big, and as you can see, I pull down. I'm just looking at the camera, but. If I pull down, you can see that headband kind of expands. You've got your little thing here to adjust the sound, which is pretty cool. These are going to take some getting used to. I do understand that. They're quite light on your head. They're not heavy at all. Which my other ones were quite heavy. That's the thing I'm going to get used to. Now you might be used to light headsets, and if so, this is perfect for you. The cushions are perfect. They're not crushing in at all, and they feel really comfortable. The sound, I've just had a test playing some music through it, and it does sound a lot better than my other ones. But probably, you know, it's not one of the high-end market ones, let's say, which, for the price, you're not going to expect it. You can pay up to 200 quid for a headset. This is only 50 quid, so you have got to bear that in mind. What else is there to talk about? I've talked about this. This like, wire band here does look kind of weird. It looks massive, but I don't have a small... I have a really big head, to be honest, but, I'm big-headed as well, but I think it might just be big. So that, like, seeing that is gonna take some getting used to. But it's all about getting used to it, I guess. the cable is huge. I've got the extension plugged in, obviously, because to there. So I'm not going to be able to do this. I stand really far back. You can kind of tell. So that I'm pulling on all the way to the headset. That's the length. That wouldn't reach my computer, but the extension reaches perfectly. There's quite a bit there. So now we're gonna do a mic test, and we're gonna see how the mic sounds. So now here's the test with the inline microphone. We're doing the inline microphone first, and as you can tell, it's all right. It is designed for on the go, and you wouldn't use this like for gaming, and especially not gaming commentaries on YouTube. It's basically for like phone calls and possibly Skype chat, but if you're going to use Skype chat, you'd probably use the boom microphone, which I'm going to test next. Right, now I'm testing the boom microphone. And with these typical boom microphones, you still wouldn't use them for YouTube commentaries, and Let's Players, whatever, you know, gaming commentaries, anything on YouTube, you probably wouldn't use these. Maybe when starting out, but as you move up, you wouldn't do these. As you can tell, every time I say like a P word, it pops. They're the plosions, and it has got a pop filter over it, but I keep doing it, but it still doesn't block it all out. So this is probably designed for talking to friends, Skype, and if you're playing games with your friends, like over the PS4, but not for gaming commentaries. The only thing I'm gonna do now is a keyboard type test, just to see how much it picks up, like around the it's omnidirectional, so it picks it up from everywhere. But I'm just gonna see how it picks up the keyboard typing. So here we go. Let's type. And there we go. So you can hear the keyboard, or I can hear it through the playback anyway, but that's it really. For this boom mic, it's the best boom mic I've ever used. The boom mic on my old headset, people from my earlier videos will know that it was terrible. I mean, I did everything to like try and cancel the background noise, but it still didn't work. And obviously we have the mute button. I'm just going to see if you can hear it click when you mute it. Let's try that. Did you hear that pop then? That is the noise it makes when you mute it, so it's cutting off. So do bear that in mind. But yeah, that is it for this mic test on the inline microphone and the boom microphone. And there we go, ladies and gentlemen. That is it for this unboxing and part review, part test of the Asus Cerberus gaming headset with a inline microphone. So the inline, which I'll point to again, is there. Like, there's a little hole there, and then the boom mic, which is here. It's your boom mic. Overall sound quality is amazing for the price. Microphone quality, because I have I can't really bring it onto the camera, but because I have a condenser microphone, it's never going to beat it. So I suppose if you're just looking for it for console gaming, well, it only works with the PS4, but if you just want it to talk to friends while playing games, there's not a problem. YouTube commentaries, I'd always look into a separate microphone. I think that was the best choice I ever made when I got my Blue Yeti. But yeah, just for talking to friends, it is fine. There's not a problem at all. And I think I've covered everything. So I will put the link in the description. I'll link you to the where I got it from, which is Amazon. I'll link you to Asus website and anything else I think you might need. And yeah, that is it. So thank you for watching this unboxing of the Asus Cerberus gaming headset. Please like, favorite, and subscribe, and I'll see you next time for some more videos like this. Ta-ra.